Hi there, I'm Brigitte Crawford, New Products Manager with North Creek Nurseries, and we're going to talk about native plants today. North Creek propagates perennials in eastern Pennsylvania, and a lot of our product offering is native plants or native plant selections.
We have been growing and promoting native plants since day one, over 33 years ago. Native plants are an important and necessary link that connect insects, animals, and people. They are an important part of the food web and our environment, so it is important that they continue to be used in our gardens, landscapes, and natural areas.
Today we're going to go into native plants a little bit. We'll talk about how we define native plants, the benefits of natives. We'll go into our production here and some of our top-selling native plants. And we'll also touch on selling natives at the retail level and how to have a successful native plant program. So why native plants? What are some of the benefits of using native plants? Native plants are well adapted to their local environment. Once established in an appropriate location, native plants typically require very little care or maintenance. There is a native plant that will fit and thrive in almost every environment. Knowing where native plants will thrive can really help in the marketing process. For example, our ground cover collection includes plants that thrive in moist, sunny environments as well as dry shade environments. One example of a plant that can do well in dry shade is Carex pennsylvanica, which is right in front of me here. Carex pennsylvanica is a sedge, and there are many sedges that are native to North America. This one is pretty popular. We actually sell more flats of Carex pennsylvanica than any other plant we grow. Native plants are a critical component of the food web. They provide habitat and food for native insects and native wildlife. These penstemon plants, for example, right in front of me, are covered with a variety of insect species, which they are providing nectar and pollen to.
Native plants provide food for the larvae of native insect species. Native bird species may find and eat the larvae on the plants. This is Antenaria plantaginifolia. It's another native ground cover, and it's a larval host for the American lady butterfly. There are thousands of native and non-native bee and insect species that benefit from native plants. Those insects also help pollinate the food crops that we eat. Some native plants are suitable for stormwater management applications, such as rain gardens and bioswales, where they help slow down runoff water and remediate contaminants that are in the water. In the back of this bioswale, you see Rudbeckia maxima. It is native, it's happy in the bioswale, its flowers put on a show and attract pollinators, and when the seeds mature, they provide food for native bird species such as the American goldfinch. All right, we've talked a bit about functionality, but native plants don't forget to bring the pretty either. They are beautiful. With the right mix of plants, you will be able to combine flowers, ornamental foliage, and textures to create year-round interest. All right, we've heard about a few of the benefits of native plants, but what exactly is a native plant, and how do we define what is native and what isn't?
So what is a native plant? One broad definition is that a native species is one that naturally occurs in a given area or region. Now that's just a broad definition without getting into specific ecological terminology. It is important to note that there are varying viewpoints within the native plant world on whether or not something is classified as native. And those viewpoints generally take into account different factors such as whether the plant occurred naturally or if it was selected by a human or if the seed strain was developed by a human. And there's even breeding work that is being done that combines multiple separate native species, and that gets even into a more gray area. Now we're going to talk about how we produce native plants here at North Creek. A lot of what we do at North Creek for production is similar to any other nursery. We have controlled environments and greenhouses, and we have a production line like you'd see anywhere. But a lot of the key differences for native plant production are because of the availability or lack of availability of buying plant propagation material in commercially or in mass quantity. And another difference is because some native plants have specific needs when it comes to their growing conditions. We propagate from seeds, from cuttings, from tissue culture, and from divisions. Here behind me, we have a bed of Allium cernuum, and we use this bed to collect seed from the plants when the seed matures. There are seed companies out there that focus on native plant species, but sometimes we can't get a particular species we want to grow, or we can't get the seeds in a large enough quantity that we want to use. When non-native species are bought in that have been bred, for example, they are typically available commercially and in large quantity, and when the seed gets planted, it's ready to germinate. However, with not a lot of native species, they basically need winter before they will germinate. So in the hort industry, that's called cold moist stratification, or CMS. And we do that here at North Creek with a lot of the native species that we grow. So this cooler behind me is where we do the CMS, and I'm holding a Rudbeckia species here. We put the seeds into a moist media, and they're actually in a bag hiding inside there so they don't get mixed in with all the media. And they are labeled with the week they went in, the week they come out, and when they will be up potted into a larger tray size if that's going to be done with them. And one other thing to note is that sometimes natives don't have spectacular germination rates. So with some species, we will sow them into a small 288 tray, and then the ones that germinate can then be up potted into a larger tray. And that way we avoid wasting greenhouse space and media with the cells that have not germinated. The native plants that we propagate vegetatively are similar to the seed grown items in that sometimes we can't find them commercially. So in the case of cuttings, sometimes we can't find them commercially at offshore facilities to purchase them in from. So in that case, we grow our own mother plants, our own stock plants, as you see here. So we do this in 2-gallon pots, in bulb crates, and also in 15-cell trays. Here you see Phloxgina, which is a selection of Phlox paniculata, which is native to here. And Gina performs top in a lot of the Phlox trials you see around the country. The yellow swallowtail butterflies absolutely love this, and we'll put in a video of these butterflies all over the flowers of Phloxgina. As far as finishing is concerned, natives aren't extremely unlike other plants. There are problem crops, of course, and a lot of times native plants don't require a lot of heavy feed, and they typically don't have a ton of insect issues either. At North Creek, since we focus on perennials, a lot of our crops will benefit from a cold period or a vernalization, and that will often help bulk them up and promote flowering.
Now let's check out some native plants that are the most sought after by North Creek customers. All right, let's check out some plants. We are in the shade. We already mentioned sedges and saw Carex pennsylvanica, but what about ferns? Here we have Aetherium filix femina, or lady fern, which is one of our popular native fern items. Other native ferns that are top sellers include Matutia stuthiopterus, or ostrich fern, and Polystichum acrostichoides, Christmas fern.
For our top-selling native grasses, we have a few here. Panicum virgatum, this selection is Cape Breeze. Schizocarium, Scoparium, Standing Ovation is shown here. A couple other grasses that are popular for us include Spirobolus heterolepis, and for moisture sites, Juncus effusus.
Since the warm season grasses you just saw are just green right now, Here are a few pictures of their interest they provide in other seasons. Here's Panicum with its inflorescence. Here is Schizicarium standing ovation throughout the year, and Spirobolus, and Juncus.
As far as other perennials that are some of our top-selling natives, we have Vernonia right behind me. That's a good one. Phlox, a whole bunch of species and selections of species are offered by us. And beyond that, we have Anarda, Eupatorium, Coreopsis, Lobelia, Asclepius, Aster, Rudbeckia, Solidago, Echinacea. The list really goes on for good natives that work well in the garden and in the landscape.
Now that we've taken a look at production and some of our most popular natives, let's take a look at native plants in a retail setting.
We're here at Gateway Garden Center in Hokesson, Delaware, and they market their native plant program with the American Beauty's Native Plants program.
Not unlike other branded programs, the American Beauty's program uses clearly identified light green pots, so special pots, and they have the brand logo on them. They also have large plant tags with good photography that show the plants and also include cultural information. If you're not using a branded program, you can use placards that are often used anyways, such as this one showing Carex apalachica. This tag shows that the plant is native, and it also shows other features that people commonly are looking for in plants, such as resistance to deer and lawn or turf alternatives.
Another way to promote and market native plants is to collaborate with nearby organizations that have similar missions. Here you see a placard at Gateway Garden Center that explains how well a plant did in the trials at nearby Mount Cuba Center. Mount Cuba Center is a nearby botanical garden where native plants are displayed and trialed. They work to inspire the appreciation of native plants and are committed to supporting the habitats that sustain them. North Creek collaborates with Mount Cuba Center. And one example is the introduction of a selection of the native species Iris versicolor.
I'm at our lower pond next to Iris versicolor purple flame. The cool thing about purple flame is that when it emerges in early spring, it has dark eggplant purple foliage, especially in wetter locations like the pond here. And as the foliage grows up, it does fade to the green of the straight species. And by the time it flowers like it is now, it's mostly green. However, you can see here that the stalks for the flowers are also dark purple.
Like any plant business, a successful native plant program relies on having a good marketing plan. It may take extra time and research to learn the ecosystem side of natives, but having a knowledgeable staff who understands customers' needs and are passionate about the product is vital. At the end of the day, a good product mix of quality grown plants, native or not, will sell themselves. Thanks for watching today. We hope you learned a bit about native plants. And if you'd like any more information about building your native plant program, feel free to reach out to us at info@northcreeknurseries.com.
We have some bullfrogs in the background. Wind going by, hopefully you can still hear me. One example of a plant that, there's a car, hold on.